Kimberly Duncan. Back from the dead. Woo!
Yeah.
Yay.
As you can see, I'm alive and kicking.
Aww.
But I'm feeling great. How are you guys feeling?
Good.
Woo! Glad to hear that.
Super.
That is a good answer. I want you to feel super. I want you to relax because we're just going to do some questions and answers and nobody's going to bother us. So who wants to ask me a question first? Raise your hand in the air. You can do that again. Woo!
Kimberly, Doug and I'm dreaming.
No, you're not. You're awake. Wow.
Oh, there's a hole there that they dropped from.
Hey, hey, David Goro.
Hello, Kimberly Duncan.
Thanks for dropping in, David Goro.
You know, that's all I really know how to do.
Really? Yeah, you know what? I beg to differ. I heard that you recently worked on My Name is Earl.
Oh. Well, I'll tell you something about Kimberly Duncan. Not her name. She lied to your face. It's kind of rude.
I know.
Mary Simpkins here. And Mary Simpkins you might have seen last year on The Tonight Show with Miss Valetta there.
Yeah. But are y'all familiar with the whole Terminator series?
Yeah.
Good. As you know, it begins with the feature film The Terminator, starring Arnold Schwarzenegger and Linda Hamilton. And they also starred in Terminator 2, Judgment Day, and that's the movie that this show is based on. That movie added the actors Edward Furlong, who played John Connor, and Robert Patrick, who played the T-1000, which is the person on top who got a hold of me a little while ago. Now, four of those actors are singing most of the movies you saw in this room and in the pre-show room. And all the movies that just mentioned were directed by James Cameron.
Yeah. But you might know James Cameron's other movies. He did Aliens, True Lies, Myth, won the Academy Award for Titanic. He only does low-budget stuff.
Yeah.
But he is the creator of our show here, Geek of 3D, which is a combination of live-action and 3D film. He's actually still working for stars. And we're performing and even speaking to the footage of his act. The first time you see me, I'm sliding down that rope, and that's something called a rappel. The rappel that I do here is 40 feet straight down, and it's a free rappel. Free of any surface. Now every day I'll do up to 10 of those repels, do up to 10 shows a day in a row, a lot of shows. But during peak season here, we do 3 shows an hour, and it comes out to 40 shows a full day. So that's 14 all day long. And we can do that many shows here because we never stop. We just keep the audience cycling, and the cast cycling too, it's great too. Guessing behind you, you've got Kelly in the booth there. Say hey, Kelly.
Hi, Kelly.
Kelly is our stage manager. She comes the entire show, all the effects that move, like that curtain. And the 3D projectors. Now above Kelly, there's a room that houses the 2 center screen projectors. They project onto this main screen, and then there's 2 projectors on the opposite side of the auditorium for each screen. Now we do have 6 projectors up there, because these were 3 separate screens you saw. They're not connected, and it does take 2 projectors to get that 3D image for each of the screens.
One ton?
Wow. That is a good guess. Actually, it weighs 2,500 pounds, which is?
And a quarter.
You're only like a fifth foot off.
Yes.
That's a good guess. Yes,
yeah, okay. Okay.
And you don't win anything, but my time. Did y'all see it move at all during the show? Anybody see the little three?
I saw the split.
It's an O. Alright, well, let's explain what that all means. Right now, we're going to show you how the Terminator enters and exits.
Whoa.
Good. Good. Thanks for sticking around. You're not feeling good today. I'm coming to California next day. It is so I ran you home taking over for today. Andy here works alongside Orlando Blue.
That's right. Thanks, Dave. Hey, Mary, how are you?
Hi, I'm good.
Good, thanks. Thanks, Russ.
How you doing?
I've got some fascinating Terminator trivia for you guys. In the movie Terminator 2 Judgment Day, Arnold Schwarzenegger was paid $15 million, but he spoke a total of only 700 words. Now, if you do the math on that quickly, that works out to over $21,000 per word. So that famous catchphrase of his, hasta la vista, baby, that would have cost producers over $85,000. Not too bad for 5 seconds' work, huh?
Well, the cast makes a little less than $15 million, just slightly. We are still actors, but we did go through a lot of work to do the show. The entire cast had to go through a training period, kind of like a mini boot camp, like the ones they do in the military. And we did that at the Los Angeles cast.
A lot of strength and endurance building exercises. Check out the big bed. And the third day we did weapons.
Speaking of big guns. It's one of the big guns we use to show. It's called our plasma rifle. We did have a little laser on so that it could seem more realistic under these lights. But when I say laser, what I actually mean is a little light bulb. Real high tech.
Whoa.
Something that's not a toy though is my motorcycle. Harley Dean, that boy I came out on, and I was carrying a real 12-gauge shotgun. Sarah Connor repels me from the catwalk. She's got a T-R-15 automatic rifle. He wants to know if we get tired. I'll tell you, there are actually a couple reasons why I don't get tired. This beats working. It really does. It really does. There's a lot of work. I can be doing. Yeah. And in some ways, audiences can be good. Post shows are really
thank you. nice time.
Nice meeting you guys.
It was a pleasure.
Great time.
Thank you. Picture taker. Good job. Okay. You're very welcome. Nice meeting you guys. Take care now.
Thanks.
Have a good time. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you.